Hi guys and welcome to Usitility. Well, we are going to discover how to launch and play The Walking Dead Survivors on PC. As you can see now, you are watching it on screen. It will be possible to efficiently download and install The Walking Dead Survivors so that we can enjoy playing the game on the Windows PC using our keyboard, mouse and big screen. Then without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, the first thing to do is to launch our main web browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to this URL that I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. You don't need to type anything, because I provided the clickable link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We arrived there on our website of Usitility, at which we have a meticulous description on how to download and install The Walking Dead Survivors on computer. We browse lower a bit and mouse click on the download game on PC button. Once clicking on that link, we get to the website of LDPlayer. Which the Android emulator that we will use to enjoy the game The Walking Dead Survivors on PC. As you can see here, we access some advantages of preferring this emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, and so on. Then, we are on the way to start downloading The Walking Dead Survivors by clicking on the button Download The Walking Dead Survivors on PC that I have marked in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Here it is. Here is located the download. It's an executable file. What we have to do now is to launch the installer, so we click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow changes to the device. We clicked yes. I reduce the web browser to find the installer better. The installation software is very simple. It includes a couple of possibilities: install, and setup path. I am going to show you what setup path genuinely does. We simply click on it. Therefore, we note that we get here the path where the emulator is going to be installed. If we have to change this directory, we are required to click on the Browse button, and therefore we pick another directory and set up the emulator where we prefer. To keep it simple, just keep it where it is. I click on Back. Therefore I pick Install. At this moment, prior to starting the installation of this emulator, it is possible that it'll show us one or two software packages to install on our laptop. Because I do not need any of these software program, I simply just click each time on the Reject button. Fantastic. The install begins and it will commence with the download of those megabytes that happens to be shown on the screen. Once you download it, it could possibly be a little bit more or less MB. The download speed can be faster or at a lower speed, based on your internet and according to the velocity of the emulator hosting servers. Now they are running superbly fast. The download is completed, then at this point it continues on with the setup phase. The setup requires more or less time depending on the power of your laptop or computer. The more powerful it really is, the faster the software installation time and vice versa. If we put together the download and installation stage, it can take a considerably long time, so show patience. It has already ended for me. At this time, the emulator has actually been started instantly. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar that will move forward to the right, and when it gets into the end, the emulator will be launched for the first time. Indeed, the emulator has been launched, there for the very first time. And as a result, LD Store is instantly launched, which is actually a kind of Google Play. It's not the most correct option to install the game, and I also don't suggest it, for the reason that quite often the LD Store installs an out-of-date version of the game. I'm going to demonstrate the best way to set up the game using the Google Play, therefore I recommend you to do it this way. First of all, we have to perform is to go to the computer's desktop by clicking on this icon that I am pointing out in green. Before we keep going, as you will notice, it made a couple of app icons here on the computer desktop. The LDPlayer and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LDPlayer app icon is the only one we are interested in. When we are planning to launch The Walking Dead Survivors on the PC, we twice mouse click on this app icon and run the emulator. The LD Multiplayer app icon isn't about multiplayer or even nearly anything like that. Of course, it is a software icon that we will most certainly never make use of. Let me conduct the next step, which is a requirement, and that is to begin to browse the Google Play Store. To execute this, we will browse here to System Apps, we click. And we are going to just click on Play Store. As you can view, the Google Play is presented. Right here we need to sign in. Presently, once we are here, we must definitely execute the next phase, which is mandatory. Therefore, we simply click on Sign In. At present it announces Checking Info. It could from time to time get stopped at Checking Info, that's why it does not advance. In this case, you may try to log in after a couple of hours, it's going to probably be corrected. At present we're going to type in our email address and password. The email really needs to be a Gmail email and its corresponding password. As an example, you may use the exact same email address you use right now in your own YouTube account. So I am going to type my information and I will go back when I have accomplished it. That's all, info inserted. Find out Google welcoming us and offering us their terms of service. We would accept them all by hitting, I agree. Then, it allows us to save to the Google Cloud. you could keep it checked and this will create a backup of the data files on this device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you do what you want. We click accept. From now Google Play is presented by default and automatically. However, if the Google Play is not started automatically and you are unsure how to launch it manually, I teach you how to get it done. The very first thing is to navigate to the emulator desktop by pressing this icon designated in green. So now we navigate to the System Apps folder. And we click the Play Store icon. Okay, I am right here within Google Play. What we intend to perform now is browse here to search for apps and games. And then we are going to look for The Walking Dead Survivors. Furthermore, there we have it, we should pick the first result. At this point we have got the video game. Let's just click here on the install choice that I'm highlighting now in green. This will commence the setup. At this moment it is going to download and install the game. It may take a bit of time or it might possibly be very quick. That all depends on the internet connection. This has already completed installing. Back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this particular button I'm highlighting in green, that allows you to launch The Walking Dead Survivors for the very first time. You are at present on the emulator desktop, and therefore we are going to mouse click on the new The Walking Dead Survivors software icon that has been provided. Your game app is launched for the first time. Here we have it. I can also mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to talk about the volume level of the emulator. This is here. We have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we will not rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of this emulator. As well as to appreciate the experience to the maximum, we could activate the big screen, for which we have two alternatives. That is simply the first one. We just click on that app icon that I am pointing out in green. Then the display screen is maximized, coming with one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In case that we would like to appreciate the game using all the screen, we mouse click on this software icon. And we might at present be enjoying the gameplay in full screen setting. To stop the full screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we'd at present be in standard screen setting. From now, I am choosing to reveal you the keyboard mapping that is surprisingly interesting. This means we will certainly be in a position to make use of the game far more easily. The first thing is to press this software icon. And at this time there you will have the ability to make the necessary controls. I am going to leave the normal configuration, though if you like to modify that, you can easily do it with no problem. I have this occasion to comment that in certain cases, when launching the game a dark screen appears. If this is so and you get the black screen and the emulator fails to commence, I comment a viable solution. We should click here, to the cogwheel. In your emulator preferences, in the advanced option we have a multitude of resolutions. This is the image resolution that we have previously selected automatically and we should select any of these additional graphic resolutions, for example that one below. We opt for it and after that simply click save. It will probably ask us to reboot the emulator and soon after restarted, most probably the emulator will get started and this black screen will go away. Clearly, the emulator is entirely in our language. In certain cases it happens that your emulator is presented in the wrong language, for example, in Chinese. And so to set it up in the proper language we click here to the cogwheel. And thus right here inside of additional configuration settings, we click the language drop down. We could determine the language we want, English, Mandarin, etc. When the language is selected, we could save, the emulator will restart, as well as the game, the next time we use it, would also be in the picked language. So now, you can find another aspect that we must take into consideration, and this is that we will receive an email saying that a new machine has been linked to our own Google account. It is going to ask us if we're the individuals who have connected that device. Absolutely, we really should not worry, because the emulator is behaving like an Android electronic device. And in order to find which electronic device is being emulated, we go here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. So we browse here to the model option. And here we determine that the emulator is emulating a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for this tutorial. I sincerely hope you appreciated it, especially that you found it interesting. If that's the case, offer it a nice thumb up, subscribe to the channel, and I will be happy to answer all your feedback, questions or suggestions, let them in the comment area below. You can also leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams ever so often, you have it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Mouse click on any of the online videos that are appearing on the screen and see you in the next videos. Bye.